Let us go to question number one. See, that order might be different for you actually. There's some randomization of the questions. That's why you may not expect in the exactly same order. Okay, take this reference and I'm going ahead. See, if, yeah, Mohan Manish, I think. Yeah. Wait, this is the question. Okay, is it visible to you clearly, this question?
Yes, sir.
Okay, let the impulse response of Valdez system is 2 power n into u of n minus 2 minus u of n minus 5. Then what is the length of the impulse response? Answer is 3. Yeah, let me go to that explanation. 2 power n into. U of n minus 2 minus u of n minus 5. This impulse response given to me, and u of n minus 2 minus u of n minus 5 means which is equals to 1 only when, yeah, for what values of n?
2 to 4.
That is from 2 to 4, right? Only for 0 less than equals to n less than equals to 4. Oh, 2 to 4, 2 less than equals to n less than equals to 4. Otherwise, this is 0, equal to 0 else. Only between 2 to 4, that is non-zero. Then the length will be upper limit minus lower limit plus 1, right? 4 minus 2 plus 1. Otherwise, you can say 2, 3, 4 indices, right? At 2, 3, 4 indices, that is equals to 1, at least this part. 2, 3, 4 indices. 1 into 2 power 2, this is 2 square, say 2 cube. And this is 1 into 2 power 4. Say 2 power 4. The length is 3, right? The first non-zero, last non-zero. You can have the difference. 4 minus 2 is 2 plus 1. Total 3, right? 3 samples. This is the length we are going to get. So length of the impulse response. Which of the following digital frequency corresponds to more frequency of oscillations than other choices? Pi by 2, 3 pi by 4, 7 pi by 4, and pi by 4. We have seen the frequency of oscillation for digital are as follows. See, omega versus frequency of oscillations. Low frequencies are nearby, yeah, nearby which one? Even multiple of pi, where k is integer. And high frequencies are nearby odd multiple of pi, 2k plus 1 into pi, nearby odd multiple of pi, where k belongs to integer. Low frequencies are nearby this, high frequencies are nearby this. For example, k equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, or k equal to minus 1, 2, 3, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, and so on. And this we saw already in our class, like it will increase up to what frequency? As I increase my omega, the frequency of oscillations will increase up to what point? Up to pi, right? Because pi is the highest possible frequency of oscillations, odd multiple of pi, right? It's 1 into pi. It's odd multiple, right? For k equal to 0, see pi. And that will decrease till 2 pi. And once again, it will increase up to 3 pi, like this, right? Here the frequency of oscillations we are going to get. And up to 4 pi, that will decrease, and so on. Increase, decrease, increase, decrease, like this, right? At odd multiple of pi, we are going to get highest possible frequency of oscillations. At even multiple of pi, lowest possible frequency of oscillations. That's what we are going to get, right? Now, in our question, pi by 2, 3 pi by 2, 7 pi by 4, pi by 4. And if you try to point out them, let me go with pi by 4. This is 2 pi by 4. This is 3 pi by 4. Pi by 4 somewhere here. 2 pi by 4 somewhere here. See, 2 pi by 4 means pi by 2. And 3 pi by 4 somewhere here. See my 3 pi by 4. Compared to these two frequencies, these oscillations are high, right? Compared to these two, this y coordinate value, this is bigger. Now only one thing left for us, 7 pi by 4. 7 pi by 4 means where we are going to get 7 pi by 4? This 2 pi is nothing but 8 pi by 4. 7 pi by 4 means just pi by 4 below this. That means this pi by 4 and this pi by 4, same oscillations, right? This is my 7 pi by 4. It's just pi by 4 away from 0. This is pi by 4 below from 2 pi. Exactly same slope, right? These two are identical frequency of oscillations. This is the highest out of these four, right? These two are identical. There is no difference between this and this. This is a little bit higher. This pi by 2. And 3 pi by 4 is much higher than this one. It means our answer is 3 pi by 4. That is 3 pi by 4. Highest possible frequency of oscillations. Which of the following is R? There can be more options. R, there can be one option also. We can't guarantee. Representing frequency response of accumulator system. Accumulator system means H of n equals to U of n. We saw already the derivation for this one in our class. That is having DC component, right? Non-zero DC component. And with the help of some recursion, we solved for U of e power j omega, which is nothing but, yeah, what is the answer for this? The two are the answers, right? Any one of the two is answer for this. It's just a change of sign, that's it, for this one. This is for DC component, 1 by 2 DC component. Pi sigma r delta of omega plus 2 pi r. That is fine. And this is the leftover part, that signum function kind of thing, 1 by 1 plus e power minus j omega. Through regression, we have done this one. Here, we are just replacing r with minus r. R with minus r. You can observe clearly, the two terms are identical. This one is same as this one. There is no difference at all. Okay, if you want clarity over this one, I'll try to write something. Can you just tell me whether these two are equal or unequal? X of n minus k. I am claiming that this is equals to this one. Is it true or false? Are they equal, this and this? If you have doubt,
so they vary as k varies.
Yeah, they are equal.
The reason, they are same.
Yeah, this covering entire plane, right? If you want, you can go for variable transformation. Variable transformation means, let me consider k dash equals to minus k, and lower limit will become plus infinity. If I replace k with k dash, then k dash equal to infinity to k dash equals to minus infinity. This k equals infinity become like k dash equal minus infinity, and x of n plus k dash, right? Like this we are going to get. And this one is nothing but this one. Both are same. They no difference at all. Both are same. They no difference at all. They are identical. Now I can change my name like k instead of k dash. There's no issue with that. Or if you want, you can expand this, right? For k equal to 0, x of n. For k equal to 1, x of n minus k. For k equals to x of n minus 2. For k equal to minus 1, x of n plus 1, right? Here you can try. This is reverse, right? For k equal to minus 1, this will be x of n minus 1. Here k equal to 1 means x of n minus 1. Here for k equal to 1, x of n plus 1. Here for k equal to minus 1, x of n plus 1. At the end, we are going to get same, right? Yeah, you can have the same thing here. These two are identical. There is no difference at all. two are the answers for this. Okay, let me go to fourth question. What is the ROC, region of convergence of Z transform for this one? It's a left-sided sequence. Minus 2 power n u of minus n minus 1 is a left-sided. And this is a right-sided sequence. 3 power n u of n. Yeah, can someone tell me what is the ROC for the first case, left-sided case? It's given like minus 2 power n u of minus n minus 1 plus 3 power n u of n. Okay, what is the ROC for this first part?
Margin less than 2.
Margin less than 2. Intersection. And what is the ROC for this?
Margin greater than 3.
3. Because this is right sided sequence, right? Is there any common part between this and this? Margin less than 2 and margin greater than 3. There is nothing like that, right? You can't find a value which is less than 2 and more than 3. It's not possible, right? They are contradicting. Implies ROC is a null set, pi. There is no ROC for this one. It means Z transform won't exist for this sequence, for this particular two-sided sequence. Let h of n equals to sine pi by 4n by pi n be the impulse response of digital system. And which are the following is are true? Here I think all the four options are correct. All of them are correct. We have already saw something in our class as follows. If impulse response h of n equals to sine omega cn by pi n, then what is this implies? Is it low pass, high pass or band pass? This one.
Low pass.
Yes, digital low pass filter with a cutoff frequency of omega c.
Omega c.
In our case, it is given like omega c equals to pi by 4. Omega c equals to pi by 4 in our case, in our problem, omega c equals to pi by 4. That's a digital low pass filter with a cutoff frequency of pi by 4. Now it's mentioned like one, this is omega, this is a one of the option, one minus low pass filter. Low pass filter that we have is ideal low pass filter, right? Minus omega c to omega c, and let me consider only up to pi, minus pi to pi. After this one, that's periodic, that's repetitive, no need to worry about that one. Minus pi to pi, just consider about this part. If I subtract this one from this, then what we are going to get if I do minus operation for this with this? This one gets cancelled out between minus omega c to omega c. We'll get 0 between minus omega c to omega c and equal to 1 between omega c to pi minus pi to minus omega c, right? If we subtract these two things, we are going to end up with this. This is plus pi. And this is minus pi, c minus omega c, c omega c. The highest possible digital frequency. The high pass filter. It's a high pass filter with a cutoff frequency of omega c once again. Now need to look into this. Consider only positive part in order to have the view of high pass filter. Consider 0 to pi interval. 0 to pi interval. For low frequency, gain is 0. High frequency, gain is 1. This is a high pass filter, right? This is a high pass filter. Now one more thing I have asked is minus 1 whole power n into h low pass of n. This part I have asked you, right? Where h low pass means h of n in our example case with the cutoff frequency pi by 4. This can be written like e power j pi minus 1 equal to e power j pi whole power n equals to e power j pi n, right? And one thing we observed in our properties is e power j omega naught n into h of n implies is a modulation property, right, of DTFT. J into omega minus omega naught implies this one, where this is a low pass filter with a cutoff frequency of pi by 4. low pass filter with the cutoff frequency of pi by 4. This is 0. This is pi by 4. C minus pi by 4. And this is plus pi. And this is minus pi. Now if I do this transformation, shifting operation, then I am going to end up with shifted by how much? Here omega naught equals to pi. Shifted by pi. 0 shifted to pi. This will be shifted to pi. It means I am going to end up with this, right? And minus pi by 4 will be shifted to. If I do plus pi for this, plus pi for this. Shifting right side by pi, right? Pi minus pi by 4. See, pi minus omega c, right? Where omega c equals to pi by 4. Pi minus pi by 4. That means 3 pi by 4. This will be 3 pi by 4, right? This will become like a high pass filter. High pass, right? This is my 0. 0 to pi minus omega c, gain is 0. Nearby pi, pi is the highest possible digital frequency. The gain is 1, right? This is a high pass filter. You can measure only from 0 to pi and you can compare. This is a high pass filter, digital high pass. With a cutoff frequency of 3 pi by 4. Yeah, this is also true. All are true in this case. And one more thing, 2 cos pi n by 2 into h of n. 2 cos pi n by 2 into h of n, where h of n is a low pass filter, digital low pass filter with a cutoff frequency of pi by 4 in this example. How to split this? Cos theta equals to
e to the power of I theta plus?
Yes, e power pi j pi j theta plus e power minus j theta by 2. By 2. 2 gets cancelled out and I am going to get this thing. Now I will have to consider these two separately. E power j pi by 2 n into h of n plus e power minus j pi by 2 n into h of n implies h of e power j omega equals to, I am going to get band pass only. That's why I am writing band pass. Yes, what will be this then? Once again, you can apply this property. E power j omega naught n into h of n implies h of e power j into omega minus omega naught. It will become like j into omega minus pi by 2. Omega minus pi by 2 plus h of e power j into, yeah, what is this? Minus pi by 2, right? Minus of minus is plus. Plus pi by 2. Like this I am going to get. And let me have h of e power j omega. This is a low pass filter. Minus pi to pi. Oh, I mean minus pi by 4 to pi by 4, right? This is pi, this is plus pi, minus pi. This again is 1. This is my low pass filter. See my h of e power j omega. And if I do that shifting operation, shifting right side by pi by 2, shifting left side by pi by 2. Let me shift this right side by pi by 2. It means 0 will be shifted to pi by 2, right? If I add plus pi by 2 to this, 0 will be shifted to pi by 2. And if I add pi by 2 to this one, it will become pi by 4, right? And if I add pi by 2 to this one, it will become like 3 pi by 4. 3 pi by 4. That will be shifted like this, right? And it will be 0. And I will go for shifting left side by pi by 2. This one. Left side by pi by 2 means 0 shifted to minus pi by 2. It means minus pi by 2 will be added to all 3. Minus pi by 2 minus pi by 4 means minus 3 pi by 4. And minus pi by 2 plus pi by 4 means minus pi by 4. This effective one I am going to get. Now, no need to worry about this side. Due to symmetry, you will get by default when that is a real signal. And just bother about 0 to pi interval. How this looks like? Is it band pass or band stop? 0 to pi interval. Pi is the highest possible frequency. Give the lowest possible frequency. Band pass, right? Band pass filter with cutoff frequencies pi by 4, 3 pi by 4. Because gain is 0, this stop band is also stop band, is a band, is pass band. A band pass filter with cutoff frequencies pi by 4 and 3 pi by 4. It means all four options are correct here. Okay, question number 6. What is the ROC for the Z transform of x of n equals 2 power n u of n minus 3 power n u of minus n minus 1? 2 power n u of n. Minus 3 power n u of minus n minus 1. What is the ROC for this? This first one? Margin greater than 2. What is the ROC for second one? This one.
Margin less than 3.
Margin less than 3, right? Intersection. This is left sided sequence. Implies there is a common part between them, right? Above 2 and below 3. Margin less than 2 and 3. This is the ROC for this. 2 to 3. That's excluding poles. If you write this one, this is including pole, right? There's a mistake. At pole that will diverge. That should be excluding poles. Okay, what are the corresponding fundamental periods for the following digital signals? Cos 2n. What about cos 2n? Cos 2n, cos pi n by 8. Cos pi n by 8. What are the things given? Cos pi n by 4. Fundamental period for this. Least possible n for which x of n plus n equals to x of n, right? I want to check this, right? Cos of 2 into n plus n. Replacing n with n plus n should be equal to cos 2n and n should be integer. Least possible positive integer, then that n is called as a fundamental period, right? It means what should be satisfied? This can be written like cos of 2n plus 2n. This should be equals to 2 pi k, where k is some integer. Implies n equals to 2 pi k by 2. It means pi k, right? Is there any chance that this can be integer? Pi k can be integer, where k is integer. Is it possible? Where k equals to 1, 2, 3 and so on. Is there any chance that n equal to pi k will become an integer? Is it possible? It's not possible, right? Because pi is an irrational number. It's an irrational number. This will never become like integer. So this is not a periodic. This is aperiodic. It's aperiodic. What about the period of this one? Cos pi, if we replace n with n plus n, then I am going to get pi n by 8 plus pi n by 8, replacing n with n plus capital N. And if I expand, I got like this. This should be equal to 2 pi into integer, where k equals 1, 2, 3 and so on. I need to find the least possible such n. Pi n by 8 equals to 2 pi k. Pi gets cancelled out. Implies n equals to 16 k. Then what is the fundamental period for this? Yeah, can you speak? What is the fundamental period for this? 16, right? For k
equal to 1.
For k equal to 1 itself, we are getting least possible n, integer. And similarly, if I replace n with n plus n, see pi n by 4 plus pi n by 4, this part should be equal to 2 pi into integer. Pi n by 4 equals to this one. Pi gets cancelled out. N equals to 8k. K equal to 1, 2, 3 and so on. The least possible we are list value of integer is n equal to 8. We are getting for k equal to 1, right? It's a period, fundamental period of this one. The fundamental period of this. Okay, what is the fundamental period for the following digital signal? X of n equals to cos pi n by 4 plus cos pi n by 5. Fundamental period for the following digital signal. Cos pi n by 4 plus cos pi n by 5. Cos pi n by 4 plus cos pi n by 5. Cos pi n by 5. This is my x of n. That should be equal to x of n plus n, right? For smallest possible integer n, positive integer. That's what I need to check. Yeah, I'll let you skip that procedure. Here we need to satisfy pi n by 4 should be equals to 2 pi k. Here that let me call it n1 by n2 divided by 5 should be equals to 2 pi into some k, like this, right? Pi gets cancelled out, implies n1 equals to 8k. Here implies pi gets cancelled out, n2 equals to 10k, right? N2 equals to 5 into 2, 10k, where k can be 1, 2, 3 and so on. K can be 1, 2, 3 and so on. Okay, what is the fundamental period of this?
8.
8, right? For k equal to 1, smallest possible integer. What is the fundamental period of this?
10.
10, right? For k equal to 1, we got. And the common period of both of them is LCM, right? This is a shortcut for that. LCM of 8, 10. 8, 10. If I go with the 2, 4, 5. 5 was 20. 22 is 40. That's 40, right? 8, 5 is 40. And 10, 4 is 40. That's fine. This is the fundamental period of this summation. 40, n equal to 40. Match the following to concern anti-aliasing filter. Anti-aliasing filter. Okay, audio signal. Yeah, what about audio signal? In general, what is the cutoff frequency for audio signal? Audio signal, what is the highest possible frequency according to your guess? Fmax should be
0 to 20 kilohertz.
20 kilohertz, right? And when coming to speech signal, yeah, that's why I gave approximation. It need not be always 4. Sometimes that can be 3.5. It depends on yeah, the type of PCM you are going to apply, that quality of speech that you are expecting. That will vary. It need not be always this one. But I gave some examples only here. Not to worry about that. See, here I consider Fmax equals to 4 kilohertz. With this constraint, see, anti-aliasing filter means anti-aliasing filter. Yeah, in general, what is anti-aliasing filter? Is low pass, high pass, or band pass? This is anti-aliasing filter, followed by sampling circuit, sampler. With a cutoff frequency, with a sampling rate of FS, samples per second. Then what should be anti-aliasing filter?
Greater than 2 FM.
No, it's a low pass filter with a cutoff frequency of FS by 2. It means the maximum frequency that we are going to allow here should be equal to FS by 2, right? That should not exceed FS by 2. That should not exceed FS by 2. And that should be low pass filter. According to that Nyquist-Shannon sampling theorem, it should be satisfied. But when coming to audio signal, you may have components up to 20 kHz, right? That's why you try to prefer. The graph you can see for this one is 20 kilohertz. The graph you can see for speech is 4 kilohertz. And accordingly, we will have our sampling rate. Here, sampling rate FS should be above twice this one, above 40 kilo samples per second. And when coming to speech, the sampling rate we are going to study above 8 kilo samples per second. FS greater than 2 FM. That's what we are going to claim. Yeah, this is just for, yeah, basic level. Yeah, that's fine. Which are the following is are true? Here the statements are all IR systems are unstable. This is wrong. The reason is there are some IR systems which are stable also, and there are some IR systems which are unstable also. Some of them are stable and some of them are unstable. It depends on your example system. FIR system is always stable. FIR systems are always stable because that is always absolutely summable. Impulse response is always absolutely summable. IR system impulse response need not be absolutely summable all the time. Let me have some examples for that. Let me go with FIR system. Finite impulse response system. For stability, impulse response should be absolutely summable, right? Mod h of n should be less than infinity. This should be finite. Then that is a stable system. When coming to FIR systems, this won't be from minus infinity to plus infinity. For example, this might be from minus 5 to 10 like that. Finite length, right? This is one example. And if h of n is finite for all samples, by default you'll get sum of finite number of values. That finite number of finite values, that's always finite, right? If a system is always stable. When coming to IAR, let me consider some example. 2 power n into u of n. Is it stable or unstable? This is IAR system. This will be from n equal to 0 to n equal to infinite, right? N equal to infinity. Length of this one is infinite duration. Is it absolutely summable? This IR sequence, sigma 0 to infinity, 2 power n. What is this value? It's infinity. It's not absolutely summable. It means this is not a stable IR system. And there might be stable IR systems also. For example, you can consider 1 by 2 whole power n u of n. This is IR system only, once again. So going till n equal to infinity, right? Sigma 0 to infinity, 1 by 2 whole power n. Yes, what is this value then? Equals to this is nothing but n equal to 0 means 1, right? 1 by 2 whole power 0. N equal to 1 means 1 by 2. And 1 by 2 whole square plus and so on. A by 1 minus r. A by 1 minus 1 by 2. That equals to 2, right? Which is less than infinity. The stable IAR system, the unstable IAR system, this one. When coming to FIR, that's always stable. And coming to IR systems, that need not be stable all the time. That can be stable. Some systems might be unstable when coming to IR. Let us consider the frequency response of an LTA system as follows. H of e power j omega equals to j cos 3 omega. Then what is the output y of n for the given input? X of n equals to cos pi n by 3. This is the thing we are having. My input is, okay, let me consider this input, cos pi n by 3, right? Pi n by 3, this is my input. And this is my LTA system, impulse response. I have given with frequency response. It's a DTFT for this. Equals to j times cos 3 omega. Cos 3 omega. And I need to find what is the concerned output y of n for this input x of n. How to find this? You have seen some examples in the class about this. What is the frequency, digital frequency of this? What is the frequency of this? Cos omega n, right? Omega equals to pi by 3 we are having. As omega n, see omega equals to pi by 3. This is the frequency I am having. Now, I can write my output y of n at h of e power j omega at omega equals to pi by 3. Pi by 3 magnitude into cos pi n by 3. And what is this phase? Phase. What is the phase we are going to have? See, angle h of e power j at omega goes pi by 3, right? Pi by 3. Now, can someone tell me what is magnitude of this one? Mod h of e power j pi by 3. Here, h of e power j pi by 3 equals to at omega equals pi by 3, replace omega equal to pi by 3. J cos pi. J cos 3 into pi by 3 means j cos pi. Okay, what is this value? J into cos pi means? Cos pi means
minus 1,
right? Is it 1 or minus 1 cos pi?
Minus 1, sir.
It's minus 1, right? Yeah, that's fine. Okay, like this I got. Now I need to find magnitude and phase of this. Okay, what is the magnitude and phase of this? I want to have R e power j theta format. R means magnitude, phase means theta. What is R here? Mod of this is 1, right? Mod minus j is 1. And what is the phase theta equals to? This is nothing but 0 minus j. 0 minus j, right? Minus j equal to 0 minus j. Then what is this? Tan inverse of minus infinity. Minus 1 divided by 0. Minus infinity. What is this? Minus pi by 2, right? It's minus pi by 2. Otherwise, if you have doubt, you can write like this also. This is minus 1 into j, where minus 1 means e power j pi and j means e power j pi by 2. E power j pi by 2, right? If I want, I can write like minus j pi also. E power minus j pi also minus 1. Then if I club both, e power minus j pi by 2. Straight away, this is in R e power j theta format, right? R equal to 1 and theta equals to minus pi by 2. Minus pi by 2. Then what is my y of n? R equal to 1. This got multiplied with 1. 1 into this one is same as that only. As pi n by 3. And phase. What is the phase I am going to add? Plus the phase is minus pi by 2, right? Plus minus pi by 2. This is the phase I am going to add. Then what is this? Cos theta minus pi by 2. Cos theta minus pi by 2. What is that? Let me consider this as theta. Yeah, what is this?
Cos pi by 2 minus theta?
Yes, cos pi by 2 minus. Because cos of minus theta equals to cos theta, right?
Yes.
And cos pi by 2 minus theta means sin theta, right? Sin theta of n. Sin pi n by 3. That will become like sin pi n by 3. Well, let us consider a discrete sequence x of n of length 5 and a discrete sequence h of n of length 6. Y of n corresponds to linear convolution of these two sequences. Then what is the maximum possible length of the sequence y of n? We have n1 equals to 5 and n2 equal to 6. Then what is the maximum possible length after doing convolution of them? Let me go with our notations, regular notations, L1, L2. length. It will become like L1 plus L2 minus 1, right? After convolution. The highest possible length we are going to get. 5 plus 6 minus 1. That equals 10. It's a 10. Let x of n and y of n represent the input-output sequences of a non-causal LDA system. This is a non-causal LDA system. I have mentioned something here, right? Y of n equals to, this is a difference equation, right? Difference equation, representation. And how can you implement the system in real time? Yeah, how to implement this? With the help of delay, you can do, right? As we discussed in our regular class itself. For example, yeah, instead of this bigger one, let me go with very small thing. Y of n equals to x of n plus x of n plus 1 plus x of n plus 2. And how to, is it causal or non-causal system? Is it depending upon future inputs? Future, right? This has a future. See, non-causal system. And if you want to convert this into a causal system, one thing I can try is, you see my input x of n. I can simply apply delay by two samples, highest possible thing. Delta of n minus 2, delay system, right? Delta of n minus 2. After applying delay, I am going to get x of n minus 2 as my output. Now, I can apply this system here. The impulse response of this system is replace x with delta, right? If I replace x with delta of n, then I am going to get this as h of n. It will be delta of n plus delta of n plus 1 plus delta of n plus 2. Then what is the output I am going to get? With this input, x of n minus 2 is my input, and if I do convolution of this one with this, then I am going to get x of n minus 2. This is just a buffer, right? And this one is advancement by 1. Replace n with n plus 1 here, and this will become like x of n minus 1. And replace n with n plus 2. N with n plus 2 means n plus 2 minus 2. 2 gets cancelled out. Plus x of n. Now, this is a causal system, right? This is a causal, this is not a function of future inputs. With the help of this delay element, I can do that, right? Delay by 2 samples. That's what I am doing here. Here, delay by 7 samples. The highest possible advancement is 7 here, right? Delay by 7 samples. Then I can try to implement that practically. It's possible, right? So that it won't be a function of a future, that output. Overall output. Suppose if this is n plus infinity, is it possible to implement that practically? In place of 7, some infinity is there, plus infinity. Then you need to apply a delay by infinite samples, right? Delay by infinite samples means that is infeasible. For example, I can give, I'll try to give one such example. Suppose my h of n equals to minus 2 power n u of minus n minus 1. This will go till n equal to minus infinity. Till n equal to minus infinity, this will extend, right? I can't implement this practically. I can't apply it. Till n equal to minus infinity, this is non-zero. This h of n. I can't apply infinite amount of delay so that I can make it like causal. It's not possible to implement, right? I can't apply infinite delay. For this particular IR system, left-sided system. Here it's possible, this is FIR system, finite impulse response system, the highest possible delay we are having, advancement is 7. Now we can apply delay by 7 samples. Okay, let us consider sampling circuit with sampling rate FS equals to 10 kilo samples per second. Match the following digital frequencies with the concerned analog frequencies. 0.4 pi, 0.6 pi, and 0.8 pi. Yeah, how to map this? Omega equals to 2 pi f by fs, right? Omega equals 2 pi f by fs, where fs is the sampling rate. So if you have doubt, always do this. Consider x of t equals to cos 2 pi f t. And you can sample this at a rate of ts, uniform sampling, at every interval ts, at a rate of fs equals to 1 by ts. Now replace ts with 1 by fs. That equals to cos 2 pi f n by fs, right? Ts equals to 1 by fs. And call this as omega. Digital frequency omega, 2 pi f by fs. Implies f equals to omega into fs by 2 pi. You can apply that, right? Omega means 0.8 pi. Replace omega with 0.8 pi. Replace omega with 0.6 pi. Replace omega with 0.4 pi. And fs equals to 10 kilo samples per second is given. Which of the following impulse response of an LTA system is, or there can be multiple options, representing a causal and stable LTA system? Okay, is it a causal? First of all, is it a causal system? The first one, which of n equals to delta of n plus 2 delta of n minus 2 plus 3 delta of n minus 11. Is it a causal system? Okay, let me rewrite that to avoid some confusions. This is my x of n. This is my LTA system impulse response, h of n. Then my output y of n should be linear convolution of x of n with h of n. Here, x of n is delta of n plus 2 delta of n minus 2. N minus 2 plus 3 delta of n minus 11. Then, yeah, what is my h of n? What is my y of n then? If I do convolution of this with this, yeah, can you respond?
X of n plus 2 yes. Into x of n minus 2 plus 3 into
x of n minus 11, right? Now, my output y of n is not a function of feature. I can say this is a causal system, right? This is a causal system. Is it stable? Stable means impulse response should be absolutely summable. From this, I can say h of 0 equals to 1 and h of 1 equals to 2 and h of, oh, is it 1? H of 2 equals to 2, right? And h of 11 equals to 3. Otherwise, h of n equal to 0, right? For all n not equals to 0 or 2 or 11, this always equal to 0. According to stability treatment, they should be absolutely summable. If I add all of them, absolute values, 0 plus 0 plus 0 something, that's 0, right? 1 plus 2 plus 3, magnitude I am constrained. 6, which is less than infinity. This is stable, right? Or by default, you can think FIR system is always stable. This is FIR system. Length is finite, right? Just 12 samples, that's it. They're finite, right? And in between, you have zeros, in between samples. The FIR system by default is stable, causal and stable, both. And when coming to second one, h of n equals to u of n. H of n equals to u of n. What about this one? H of n equals to u of n. Is it a causal system? Causal system means h of n equal to 0 for n less than 0. This is equals to 0 for n less than 0, right? This is a causal system. Whatever stability is stable or unstable?
Unstable.
It is unstable, right? It's unstable system. Because it's not absolutely summable. Sigma u of n mod u of n. N equal to minus infinity plus infinity equals to sigma n equal to 0 to infinity. This is always fun. We are adding one infinitely many times. Infinity. It's unstable. Causal but unstable. And h of n equals to u of n minus u of n minus 100. It means h of n equals to 1 for all. Yeah, what values of n?
1 to 99.
Yes, 1 to 99, this is non-zero. Equals to 1, right? Otherwise that is 0. And this is a causal system. This is a causal system, right? H of n equals to 0 for n less than 0. N less than 0. This is a causal system. And this is stable also because this is a FIR system. If you want, you can add. The summation is 100, right? If you add all those values, you are going to get 100, which is less than infinity. And next one is h of n equals to 0.44 and u of n minus 2. Point 0.2 whole power n u of n minus 2, right? Okay, what about 0.2 whole power n u of n? Is it causal or non-causal? This is equal to 0 for n less than 0, right? Due to this factor. It's a causal system. Is it stable?
Yes, sir.
Stable, right? 0.2 whole power n, n equal to 0 to infinity equals to 1 by 1 minus 0.2. It's 1 by 0.8, right? Which is less than infinity. This is stable. Similarly, this is also causal and stable. To create some confusion, I have given n minus 2. That's it. If you have doubt, can you just expand this 0.2 whole power n u of n? See, 0.2 whole power n u of n means for n equal to 0, this is 0.2 whole power n u of n. For n equal to 0, this is 1 whole power 0. For n equal to 1, this is 0.2. For n equals to 2, 0.2 whole square. It's decreasing, right? Less than 1 whole power something. The decreasing sequence, right? 2, 3, and so on. The decreasing exponential like that you can expect, and so on. It's a causal and stable. Now, 0.2 whole power n into u of n minus 2. What are the meaning of that? 0.2 whole power n u of n minus 2. What are the meaning of this? Okay, I'll try to write like this. Is it true or false? U of n into u of n minus 2. Is it true or false? It's true, right? U of n minus 2 into u of n equals to u of n minus 2. If you want, you can check. Substitute n equals 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. It's true. That's what we are doing. This got removed, this part. We have only from this part, right? So this is a causal system. Because for n less than 0, that is 0. Including this also 0. And this is stable system, right? See, when you are including these two terms, we got finite. We are just excluding them. This is much less compared to earlier one, right? Still that is less than infinity, this is finite. If you want, you can add them. There is no issue for me. You can start doing this. 0.2 whole square plus 0.2 whole cube plus and so on. And you can take 0.2 whole square common. If you take 0.2 whole square common, then we are going to end up with 0.2 whole square into 1 by 0.8, which is less than infinity. Yeah, that's also fine. Okay, this is already late, right? Okay, is it okay to continue the session in the afternoon 2:30? We have 25 more questions as well. Okay. I'll stop recording.